Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you for all the tears, all the giggles.
Thank you for breaking barriers.
Thank you, Will and Grace. I'm going to miss you tremendously.
I feel like it was one of the very first comedies that I ever really appreciated and quoted. Like it's one of those TV shows that you look back and you remember all these quotes, whether it's just Jack or, you know, just like little things. And I feel like it really kind of shaped me into becoming the actress that I am today.
Everybody was incredibly warm and welcoming and supportive. They could kind of tell that I was out of my depth, and they were very, very helpful.
And then watching this show has helped me get a glimpse into this whole other world where I learned about what inclusion for LGBT people is supposed to look like.
It's funny, it's sad, it's emotional, it's real.
Will and Grace has been so, it's so special for me to get to do it because I always loved watching it when it was first on, and it's just such an amazing group of the most talented people, and so just to get to work with them and hang out with them, and I guess those are the main things I got to do with them. It's just been really special.
I didn't know any gay people. I didn't see any gay people. It wasn't something that was discussed. And naturally, there were negative messages about that everywhere. So to be able to see two men live authentically and live out and proud and who were successful and loved for exactly who they were by the people around them, it really gave me such a strong feeling of validation and knowing that I could have that someday too. And I do have it now.
Being here this week on Will and Grace for this show, this special Will and Grace tribute to I Love Lucy, has been absolutely astounding. Especially backstage. The wigs, the makeup, the specificity of all the details, the costumes, the prop department. Watching them prepare for the scenes that they're doing, recreating it with such heart and such realisticness is really, that I think that's the thing that's warmed my heart the most.
I grew up with Will and Grace in my house, and it was certainly the only gay thing in my house other than me. It meant so much to me, and meant that I was going to be able to have a future as a gay man, because when you're growing up in a small town in Tennessee, you are sometimes not so clear about that, although.
They had an episode where Grace talked about the sexual assault that she'd survived, and as someone who went through that as well and knows people who have gone through that, it was just nice to see representation on a platform. We don't get representation often.
For me, Will and Grace has been more than just a sitcom with exceptional writing and extraordinary performances by its brilliant actors. It has been like an awakening. It has been my support system when I used to feel low. It has been my therapy. It wouldn't be an exaggeration if I say that Will and Grace has played a major role in me accepting who I am.
You know, I'd heard all these rumors that Will and Grace was coming back, and Max Mutchnick, one of the creators, called me and said, "We're gonna bring you back." I said, "You killed Beverly Leslie. The only thing left of him was opera slippers. He put..." "Whoa, whoa, whoa," he said. "We've got a great idea. We're gonna bring you back, not as Beverly Leslie, but as evil twin, Leslie, Leslie." He was kidding, but I believed him. I showed up ready to be Leslie, Leslie.
The fact that this show exists when it first came on was so important to me. I had a stepdaughter. It was so much a part of us teaching her who we were, and it really, I think, healed a lot of people. It brought people together. We've seen quite a difference in our lifetime, and I've been on the front lines, and so it's been wonderful to be here as part of this on just such a bigger scale. So thank you so much for including me. It has been a real gift, a real treat, and everybody has been so kind to me.
I was a filthy young woman when I started on the show, and now I'm a filthy old woman. And I'm grateful that they kept bringing this brilliant character back, and I will miss this company of actors and this company of characters, and I'm so happy I was a part of it.
I just want to say, as an LGBTQ artist, thank you to everyone involved in Will and Grace, from the executives who greenlit it and took the chance on it, to the writers who had the courage to voice their truth and also make it hilariously delivered, and to the cast who took on these roles and made them so lovable. We're so grateful to all of you, and we wouldn't be where we are today without you.
Many people tell me that is one of their favorite things that I have ever done. So I'm really, really honored to have been a part of this monumental piece of American television history.
I remember when I was in high school, I used to sneak up to my parents' room while they are downstairs to watch Will and Grace. I remember for those brief moments during the time in my life, I felt visible. I felt validated. I felt noticed.
And you've really helped me in being the confident man I am today, in accepting myself and embracing who I am.
The level of writing is so good with how you do a scene and then they make it better and better and better. It was just like the greatest creative experience. And I remember, I think I did something silly with my leg at the end and they were like, do that again. And just working with the whole crew has just been a joy, like a real dream come true.
The thing about Will and Grace for me is I didn't realize I was on it for a few years, and then I was up in San Francisco and somebody was like, Larry, Larry! And he came running towards me from across the street and he said, Larry! And he said, you're Larry, right? And I said, no, I'm Tim. And he said, but you're Larry on Will and Grace. He said, my partner and I adopted a baby and named her after Larry and Joe's baby on Will and Grace. And I felt really honored.
Will and Grace pretty much taught me everything there is to know about life, have taught me to love, taught me to laugh.
Will, Grace, Karen, Jack, and everyone who's been a part of Will and Grace, I love you. You'll never know how much you mean to me and how much you meant to me growing up. Congratulations.
From a boy who grew up in Maryland years and years ago, who watched this show before he even thought of being an actor, to now being able to say he was a part of this legendary, well-oiled machine, means the world to me.
There was nothing in my world at the time that ever told me that I would ever be successful as a gay man. And Will and Grace showed me otherwise. To see Will Truman, a successful gay man in New York City, and all of his hilarious friends, really gave me something to look forward to in life. Something that I previously didn't have.
It feels incredible to be on Will and Grace because it's such a funny and such a beloved show, but it's also such an important show for representation for the LGBTQ community. It's just amazing to have queer storylines and narratives on television, especially so long ago when the show started airing. So I feel very, very lucky to get to be a part of that history.
My 8 years on the show, it's been a sure delight. It's been the nicest thing that's ever happened in my career to work with these charming people. They're so professional, so good at what they do, and they fill me with love. And that's an emotion that just spills over. The audience feels it. We all feel it. It's a wondrous thing. Thank you.
Hey, what has Will and Grace meant to me? Well, it's meant that I got to really find out a lot of things about myself in terms of comedy and what I could do, and it's meant that I've gotten to see a true one-of-a-kind and a consummate professional in the form of Jimmy Burrows, our director, at work. He directed every single episode.
You know what I love about this job and being on the show, Will and Grace, is that I was so unaware of the lives it would change when I first got the job back in 1998. And so I'm most proud of being a part of something that was bigger than all of us, that had helped change so many lives.
Laughter every single day for 11 seasons. And that is something that is so indescribably beautiful and healing and joyous. And I know I will never have it again.
Someone asked me the other day what the difference between how I felt about Will and Grace the day we started and how I feel about it now. And I said, you know, probably that day I was worried that Will Truman would be my epitaph. And now I'm just so grateful that Will Truman will probably be my epitaph.